The Dawn Treader is Narnia. It was very, very special, very original. It's the star of the movie.
It was really fascinating to work on it, and the, you know, the mechanics of it is mind-blowing.
It was magical, actually, to shoot on that set. You're surrounded by this beauty, and you can kind of lose yourself in that world. We have the return of Reaper Chief.
Oh, Your Majesty.
Who, for a lot of people, is the absolute hero of this story.
That's the spirit! We have ourselves a duel! Yeah!
He's brave, he's courageous. He's just the epitome of Narnia, I think.
My friends, we have arrived.
Man the longboats! Furl the sail and prepare to drop anchor!
In Voyage of the Dawn Treader, there are, you know, the Narnian creatures that we expect. There is the lion Aslan, and then we have fauns and centaurs.
For Narnia!
It's an old Narnian sword.
There are seven such swords. Gifts from Aslan to protect Narnia.
You need to find the seven swords of the seven lost lords, and that will be the way that they can defeat this evil that's spreading through the land. Lucy is confronted with her temptation.
Learning about the world so much when you're a child, and you're learning about what is good and what is bad. She's going through that stage where everybody feels insecure. The Magician's Garden was amazing because just the creativity behind it.
What sort of creatures are you?
The duffel pugs are these one-footed creatures. They're so crazy and weird.
This place just gets weirder and weirder.
It's a bit of a battle and a tussle with, you know, some bad guys. And that was fun to shoot in itself.
It was a great fight. I mean, it's so fast. And what I love is it's so rough and tumble, you know.
They free the people of the Lone Island.